Everybody out there in the Craft Chest Nation, it's I Craft Chest here, and as you can see, we have emptied out the Defiant, and we are going to be doing a refit test fit to see how 18s are going to sound inside of the sound chamber. Now, obviously, back here, I'd have to do some fancy, elaborate build in the trunk area in order to get an 18 to fit back here, or even two of them. Two of them is not going to have enough airspace overall because of the angles and nooks and crannies and all that. So back here is going to be the power station area, and we'll go ahead and we're going to lay plates down and all that. I don't know exactly what we're going to do here. I may turn that back into a spare tire compartment, but I don't even know where the jack is, so we'll worry about that down the road. All right, in the back seat area over here, if you can see it, what I did was I took this deck where the two Sounddown 12 sat, flipped it around, and as you can see, the notches still ride on that little bump right there, and that gives us a nice test platform. As you can see, I got a 2x4, and we'll, you know, clean this up, and it's not going to be permanent, but this is going to give me an idea of how 18s are going to sound in here. We started off with one in a box, and that's what I'm doing this week, is building a box to put in here, and I'm actually about to trim it down and clean it up. And yes, it's MDF right now. The reason being that I went this route is because birch is only available in 2x4 sheets at very limited quantities. As you can see right there, we have a birch top, which is behind there. You see this piece right here. I'm gonna cut the angles in here for this box. This box will be 4.5 cubes, not counting the port area here. But just up in this area here is going to be 4.5. So it should be a pretty good build to get an idea of how 18s are going to sound in a car. Start off with a single 18. Then we'll go as we can find some birch. And I'll just start buying sheets of birch as I can find them. It's just non-existent down here right now. I mean, I asked, looked around. There was a place that they could do special orders. But I'm not trying to pay $200 a sheet. So pack all that mess. So we're going to do this week, and I think it'll be pretty cool. So what we have going on is a box that should be tuned right around 32 to 35, if my calculations are correct. All right, should be, in theory. I don't know exactly what it's going to be. I'll give final measurements out there, and one of you calculating gurus can give me the overall. I don't know, I know one of you would know, but we have in here roughly is across here is 22 to the port, 21.5 I think it is, 18.25 and 20 deep exactly. Double baffle is going to be on here. We have a birch baffle, which I'm going to be putting T-nuts in with Allen, because I don't want any, you know, screw downs into this MDF holding a subwoofer. So we're going to be using T-nuts for that. And what I'm in the process of doing now, I have the jigsaw out, and I have this line to cut off right here. Now, this was a bunch of test fitting and bumping in and shaving off. That's why I ended up with the tail, which is no big deal because I have a router that where we're going to be doing some nice round overs and some, what do you call them, chaffering bits or whatever you call it, and some nice little 45s and all that. So I do have a router, full set of bits, and I want to get a rabbiting bit to actually kind of countersink the subwoofer in just a little bit, to give extra room for those bolts to catch the threads. If not, we'll drill up, we'll countersink the T-nut anchors and be done with it. All right, so that's where we're at right now. So we'll have a quick little look at this. This right here is gonna be a rough cutout board to seal up the gaping hole that you see all the way through the car right there. And eventually, we're probably gonna go drop down to like a 1/2 inch piece of birch out of this. Maybe just regular 1/2 inch white wood, blonde wood. No, that's another thing. You know, they didn't even have blonde wood. Blonde wood, white wood, that other fancy finished on one side. Plywood, like I like making desks out of, like my actual computer desks and aquarium stands, et cetera, so forth. I love that wood. They didn't have that. I mean, they were out of good wood. That place looked like the apocalypse hit. I wish I would have taken some pictures. Actually, I should have. Because Lowe's at Home Depot, they were all jacked up. Lowe's more so than Home Depot. I don't know what they had going on. But here we go. This is where. Sub's going to sit here. Port's going to be here. All right. It doesn't look big enough, but the measurements that I have are 4.5 in this area right here, here to here, not counting the port area, plus displacement, which they say is 0.25. I don't really dig that number, but that half should compensate for any of the displacement of boards and all that good stuff. All right, so there we go. Got to do the angles. Got to get this, got to caulk it up, clean it up. And this is just a rough draft, everybody. Final form, if this sounds good, if I can actually get it in the car, the ultimate build that will end up in the Defiant will have to actually be built in the car. This right here, just gonna get us going, sound check, and there you go. Stay tuned for more. It's a Crack to the Mind. Go out there and have some fun. Woo!